of Jamaica Virtual Vibes. This today session, we will show a very unique property in Jamaica, and we have a team in Jamaica and the UK here to assist you with all your questions. I don't know if that video just now gave you a hint. You put in on your dancing shoes, you saw a bit of luxury. Is anyone wearing their luxury hat today? Be sure to wear your luxury hats, because today we are featuring Geejam, and the prize giveaway for £25 on Jamaica Rewards will be to the winner who's wearing the most luxurious hat today. So I'm your host, Ramsey, and I'll just allow the rest of the team to introduce themselves.
Hello, everyone. Greetings. This is your spirited girl, Paula, and it's really great to be here for another installment. Enjoy the show.
Good afternoon, everyone. Elizabeth Fox, Regional Director of the Jamaica Tourist Board here in London.
Hi, everyone. I'm Jenny, and today I'm going to be bringing you the Culture Club.
Good morning, everyone. Hope you are all surviving down in Jamaica. We hear, think of you. Good morning to the agents. I'm Donovan Donaldson. Here for you. Any questions, shoot them this way.
Hello, everyone. I am Afia. Welcome to another session. I'm excited to show you all that we have in store today. So tune in or stay tuned in.
And now we'll hear from the team from Geejam. Kamla, you want to kick started? Tell us about your property.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Geejam Hotel. It's great to have you here today. We'll be presenting our beautiful hotel to you, and I'm the hotel manager. Over to you, Newton.
Hello, everyone. I am Newton Nelson. I'm the guest services director at Geejam. Welcome to everyone.
Hi, I'm Christine Douglas. I'm the duty manager here at Geejam, and looking forward to a great tour with you. Show you our wonderful property, so you'll all want to just hop on a plane right away.
Well, Christine, from the background that you're showing, yes, I agree. I will want to jump on a plane right away. Anybody else on the chats want to get away? Look how stunning that room is. But now we're going to ask Christine, Kamla, and Newton just to speak a little bit about their property. And we do have some questions for them. So if you have any questions about Geejam, please put them in the chat, and they're here for you. They're here to answer all your questions. Afia?
Yes. All right. So my first question that I have, and I know this is a tag team, so anybody who wants to respond from the cadre of Geejam staff that we have here. So I want to find out, firstly, how does the layout of the property add to the allure of the resort itself? That's the first question I want to ask.
Newton,
you're muted.
Hey, sorry about that. So repeat the question, please.
So I'm saying, how does the layout of the property, how does the layout of Geejam add to the sheer allure of the resort?
Well, what I have seen and what persons have said, based on the structure, we have the cabins that are somewhat unique and secluded. They are, for me, I have a different name for each one. So like Rocksteady, I think it has the most beautiful view on property. Then I have Mento, which I call is in the wood. That is like, it's in the trees and it's very secluded. It has a hammock there, and persons tend to like it because it's of its privacy. And then you have Skia. So each cabin gives that difference, and it doesn't give you that resorty feel because you have your own private balcony and everything. You don't see persons if you don't want to see anybody. And then the Roomba rooms, they are to die for. That's what Christine is in right now. They're very modern, they're very spacious. They are what a person would dream for being at a resort. And at the end of the day, you're still in a rainforest setting that gives you that natural feel that you are away from civilization in some way. So you have a mix of civilization and nature intertwined. And then we have the villas. They are three different things that you can, each one has something totally different that you look at. And that in itself brings out a lot of persons to really enjoy. And what I say to a person when they're checking in is that Geejam likes to show off their property. So if you're booked in a Roomba, we'll show you the cabins if it's free. We'll show you the villas if it's free, because we like to show off what we have. Because who knows, you might just like it and want to come back and upgrade to something else. So we the setting is just perfect. It's just perfect for everyone.
Well, thank you for sharing that. And with that, you mentioned privacy. So if I'm someone who is very keen on privacy, what would be the best accommodation type for me to select? Or what would you suggest would be the best accommodation for me if I'm very, very much keen on privacy?
I would suggest a villa. That would be the best, because the villas are locked away.
More secluded.
They're very secluded. They're very private. It's fully staffed. So you don't have to mingle with anyone else. If you can afford to book one of our villas like Ecocasan or Panorama, you will have everything at your disposal without having to come to the general property.
Okay. All right. I needed to ask that question because I know that we have some agents on that have clients that are very peculiar about their privacy. And so they want to know what is in store for those clients that are very, very, very selective or picky when it comes to their level of privacy. And the last question I want to ask you is, I know that there is a world-class recording studio at Geejam that the likes of the late Amy Winehouse has recorded at, Sade has recorded at. Can you just speak a little bit about that recording studio? Why is it so important? What's happening there now? I'm not going to name drop anymore. I'm going to leave it up to Geejam reps to tell us why that recording studio is just so special.
One unique thing about our studio, we have a physical studio and property, which is under renovation now, but it does not stop anybody from coming here and recording. As I spoke about the villas and the privacy, there are persons who come here and they want that seclusion, that privacy, and they still want to do recording. What we have done in the past and we still do is we'll recreate that studio wherever you are. So if you're by Panorama, we'll use that living space to become a world-class studio. If you are down by Geejam, we can even build a studio in the gym. If it's in their room, we can put the studio wherever you are comfortable to record. And that's one of the beautiful parts of our studio setting, that we don't use a physical space that is designated for a studio. We will take the studio wherever you are on property. So persons like that feel they can have their privacy and the studio's right at their back door if they want to go and record every day.
I would agree, because then you have that flexibility, you know, wherever the creativity hits you and you feel like you want to record in this space, you can go ahead and do that. So thank you so much, Newton, for answering our questions. And over to you, Shanika.
Thank you, Afia. Thank you, Newton. So we've heard of privacy. I know Geejam will have their fair share of celebrities. Don't know if I'm on property, if there's any chance to see them. You know, we're always looking forward to see some celebrities anytime. Maybe one place that we may see them is at the bar. So Paula, did you manage to see any celebrity while at the bar getting your spirited report?
Well, you know what? I had every intention of doing that. But as they say, it's luxury and privacy is also the name of the game. So if you don't want to be seen, then you will not be seen. You know, but I didn't run into anyone at the bar. Maybe, but next time for sure. And for the spirited report drink this week, you know, Geejam is a very well recognized brand, very good brand value. And so this week, the spirited report is just a notch up. It's Estrella that we're going to drinking this week for the spirited report, Shanika. One for the.
All right. You know, Paula is always taking one for the team. Let's see what she's up to today.
Farm cocktail. Estrella translates to star, which is made from fresh star fruit, fresh pineapple juice, orange liqueur, and also solitude vodka. Alright. Alright, so for this drink, we'll be using 2 ounces of solitude vodka. Also, we'll be using 1/2 ounce sugar syrup and also 1 ounce of freshly made pineapple juice. Alright, this cocktail is also made from freshly modern star fruit as well. Hence the name Estrella. So we're going to just slightly crush the star fruit.
Looks delicious. So, Christine, just a quick question. When you're on property, what is one of the activities that you most enjoy doing that's close by in the community?
Well, apart from our beautiful private beach, where you can go kayaking and watch the turtles swim, stingrays, and just tour the different natural aspects that we have here in Portland. Close by, we have river rafting on the Rio Grande, which is kind of like its own little booze cruise, natural booze cruise, because we said it would igloo of different beers, spirits, anything like that that you may want. You stop on the way and you get meals provided if you want to. Great Jamaican meals by this wonderful woman that just cooks right there on like a bamboo hut type of thing. Real authentic Jamaican food. As well as there's several falls that you can visit. Reach Falls, Somerset Falls, Turtle Bay Cove, just... you can't even list them all right now, but there's a lot of natural resources that you can visit because it's, you know, eco-friendly area, the most of that. So there's no water parks. It's natural water parks that we have, as well as horseback riding, that kind of a thing. That's what you're looking for, but then Portland and Geejam is the place for you.
Perfect. You know, I like the fact that you said that it's all natural, and given that visitors are looking for their privacy, they're also looking for natural experiences.
Exactly.
In our culture club right now, Jenny's just going to touch on one of the attractions that you can do in the Port Antonio area, And I know you mentioned Booze Cruise. So here's one of our party locations in the Port Antonio area. And Jenny will speak about that.
Today, we are focusing on all things luxury. And when we think of luxury, we think of having access to absolutely everything. Frenchman's Cove Resort in Port Antonio was the world's first all-inclusive hotel in the early 1960s, where the guests were given tokens for drinks, and it attracted the likes of Queen Elizabeth, Elizabeth Taylor, the Beatles, Ian Fleming, and Errol Flynn. And these famous guests traveled to Port Antonio by boat and paid approximately $200 a week in an all-inclusive services. But it was in 1978, however, that the term all-inclusive really meant all-inclusive, when Couples Tower Isle opened as the first completely all-inclusive resort in the world. Everything was included: meals, drinks, on-site activities, and excursions. And since then, all-inclusive resorts have exploded on the tourism scene. But remember, it all started in Jamaica.
Now we will hear from our regional director on the latest with Jamaica.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. See, Shanika, I got my luxury hat on, as you said.
Yeah.
Well, there's no new news this week on travel protocols. Our current travel advice from Jamaica is still current until the 31st of August. So everything's copacetic at the moment. I must say that flights are operating very full out of the UK into Jamaica during August. So we're absolutely delighted that people are getting on that plane and going to Jamaica. I guess people realize how much good value it is to jet off to Jamaica, all inclusive of sunshine, warm sun, warm people, fantastic resorts such as Geejam. I haven't been to Geejam myself for many years, too long actually. The owners are British guys as well. It's an amazing unique property. I'm going myself over to Jamaica next week. Yay! So I'll see you guys in Jamaica who are there. I'm looking forward to it. And I guess that's it until we hear what the latest update, which will be out on the 1st of September, but we don't expect anything to change. And we're very happy to see so many people going out this summer. So keep up the good work, travel agents. We appreciate you.
Thank you, Liz. And, you know, Liz said that she hasn't been for a while to Geejam. So hint, hint, she's going to Jamaica. But but just to give her a teaser of what's there and what is the room types are for Geejam. Let's just have a preview of their property.
Thank you. Jamaica, no, how you do? Baby, tell me how much I could pay, oh. I will go fly, go anywhere for holiday, oh. This love, now I long go, oh. This love, now I'm tick-tick, yo. They could play like with the movie, oh. They can play where you go, they play mommy, oh. Mommy, oh, mommy, oh, mommy, oh. Girl, now me go, they play daddy, oh. Girl, if you be baby, I be nanny, oh. See how she fine like a granny, oh. Yeah. Show my wife, show my girl, and go, oh. Why show my wife to roll it, oh. Baby, make a day where you dey, oh. Come make a show you special loving. Show my wife, show my girl, and go, oh. Why show my wife to roll it, oh. Baby, make a day where you dey, oh. Come make a show you special loving. Anyway, you dey, I go
tell. Right. Really, really looks amazing. So I'm just going to ask Kamla to just quickly speak on the type of room types that you saw just now and give us maybe a quick overview to say what's the benefits of staying in each room type.
Okay. Thank you, Shanika. For the Roomba is our newest addition. So we have 12 units. Then you saw the cabins. The cabins are the individual units. So they're not semi, they're detached units. So they're all on their own in secluded areas. So that offers privacy, exclusivity. You're on your own. It's your own balcony. It's your own patio. It's your own private jacuzzi. And you're the only ones there. So you don't have to share with anyone. Then you saw the villas. The villas are the more exclusive properties. We have Panorama. We have Coco San. As Newton stated previously, the studio is currently undergoing renovation. So what you saw in that villa is the studio equipment relocated to the villa. So we still do take studio bookings. We still do recordings. What we have done is just relocated to wherever you book. So say you book a cabin, you book a Roomba, you book a villa. The studio equipment is relocated to whichever location. Now, in terms of privacy and exclusivity, as Newton stated, the villa would be the ideal selection, right? However, the cabins do offer that privacy as well. The Roomba is more hotel type setting. So it's all one building with 12 units.
All right. So question in the chat to say, what is the charge for the recording studio?
Now, this charge for the recording studio depends on the duration. It depends on the duration of stay, the hours that you're recording for. But on average, it's approximately, I would say, less than $1,000 per night.
All right, perfect. Now, I'm not seeing any more questions in the chat, but if you have any questions, please let us know. Camille, Christina, Newton will be on. And just to show you a little bit of preview of another attraction that's close by. We mentioned, Christine mentioned all about the waterfalls and the natural experience. Let's check out the one-stop location. I will check back to see if you have any more questions for Kamla. And I know Torrance, the Oracle's report, he's not here today with us, unfortunately, but we do have Donovan with us, and Donovan will be covering for the Oracle's report. Donovan?
Yep. Ah, hope you really enjoyed seeing those images and really make you feel to head to Port Antonio. I'm going to speak a little bit more about Jamaica Luxury, and we do have a cluster that we call the Jamaica Luxury Cluster. So before I go on, you think private, you think spacious, bespoke, unique, edgy, with true Jamaican hospitality. And that is what the properties that are part of the cluster offer to our guests. So Geejam included in the group of hotels that make up the cluster. So what do we offer to our travel agents? And one of the things that we have offered in the past couple of years, unfortunately, due to COVID, we have had a break. But one of the main things that we've done is hosted top travel, luxury travel professionals at our signature style Jamaica luxury events, where they are given a product update. And this has worked very well. And again, adding on to what Liz had said a while ago, we thank you for the business. I know that the seats are all filled or mostly filled. We do have an increase of upper and business class seats. And from Heathrow, Virgin Atlantic into Montego Bay and British Airways, obviously from Gatwick also into Montego Bay as well. So there's an increase in the luxury market here and the seats are being filled. I was speaking to an agent earlier today and she had an issue trying to find seats going over Christmas. So we quite thank you guys for all the work that you have done to fill these seats. So another thing we do, we have fam trips and we have some fantastic fam trips we've had in the past. When you think of it, they're not rushed. You're not seeing a million properties per day. And you actually get to experience each of the properties while you're on the fam trips. We have a dedicated to luxury e-zine. Everybody is going online now and everybody using the thumb. So we have an e-zine which is developed. So you can see everything luxury on our Jamaica luxury e-zine. One thing I learned today, which I did not know before, is that a lot of the private jets that come to Jamaica, the majority are from the UK. And that really surprised me. We do have facilities on island to accommodate the private jets in Montego Bay. There is the IAMJet services, and they have a luxury offering to your clients. And also close to Montego Bay is Boscobel, and in Boscobel, there's the Ian Fleming International Airport that caters only to these private jets. So that was something I learned today and decided to share with you. Port Antonio, again, a lot of things have been said, but a lot of people don't realize we have a fantastic harbor there, Twin Harbor, and a lot of the luxury yachts and boats also come into the harbor. So that's something that you should remember if clients want that kind of experience. And to wrap up on today's little talk, we do have a lot of luxury DMCs that offers all the transfers you need, all the tours you need. So if you want a helicopter, there are people who can accommodate you. So that's it for me, nice and quick and short. And if you have any questions, do let us know. Over to you, Shanika.
Thanks, Donovan. You know, you mentioned about yachts and quickly it came to mind that we do have the annual Marlin tournament in Port Antonio yearly too. So if you're staying at Geejam, then possibly you may be able to go and experience and participate in the Marlin tournament. There is also an event called Tight Lines that's associated with the Marlin tournament now. So with privacy, you do have entertainment and a little bit of luxury sport to add. Denise, I see your question in the chat and I'll just allow Kamla to respond. So Kamla, how can agents book with Geejam? That question can be pointed to Kamla or Christine Newton. How can agents book with Geejam?
Okay, we do have a website. They can go online and book, or they can call us to book directly with us, or they can book through a travel agent.
All right. Is there any commission for travel agents to book with you?
Sure, certainly, there is a commission.
Right. So we will try and share all the information in a follow-up email so you can have the social angles for the property as well. And just to inspire you with the natural beauty that surrounds Geejam, here is Afia's one-stop location. Where was Afia this time? Let's see.
In Port Antonio naturally, and trust me, this location is just about an hour outside of the town of Port Antonio, and the legend has it that when the enslaved Africans in the plantations that were in close proximity to these fogs, when they got here, they would have said Mirage, which is some part of for you. No, this is great for families, it's great for couples. They also have a picnic location here as well. And I could easily see you spending the entire day. Now, there are some special spots along these falls or in close proximity to these falls that I'm going to be taking you to today that when you visit, you definitely have to let your tour guide take you to. And he will be taking me on my adventure up Reach Falls right now.
How amazing is that? That'd be a wonderful experience. Yes, you are brave to do that. Would anyone else travel to Jamaica to do that activity? How beautiful is that? Afiel, were you scared, Afiel, going into that hole?
Did you see my face? I think those are the most like crazy faces anybody has ever seen me do when doing the one-stop session. But yeah, I was just a little tad, you know. Scared. I don't want to use that word, but it was beautiful though. Like once you went into the water and you went through and the guide is there with you to make you feel comfortable. So it was great. I was just, you know, being silly and but it was amazing. I think one of the most, as a Jamaican, I'd say one of the most amazing things. I know I keep saying amazing, wonderful. Let's use a different word. One of the most wonderful things about Reach Falls is that the water actually looks like seawater. It doesn't look like river water. It looks like you're at the beach. if you notice that blue. So, yeah. Yeah.
You know, Daryl is saying you're brave. Debbie saying that she would be scared. Jill is saying that she may have to add it to her bucket list for 2023. And Denise is saying it looks refreshing, but she would be scared. So, yes, Carol says so brave. You know, do let us know if you've booked any clients to go to Jamaica recently. You know, if you've had any bookings coming in. You know, if you're celebrating any birthdays, any anniversaries, any special occasions, let us know in the chat. We'll give you a shout out. You know, we will be taking a quick break from Jamaica Virtual Vibes just for 3 weeks. You'll miss us and you'll miss all this entertainment, but we will be coming back with some more episodes, exciting Virtual Vibes on the 15th of September. You know, we're just taking this quick break just so you can enjoy the rest of what is supposed to be summer. I know outside isn't sunny right now, but, you know, just to allow you that break, and we'll come back sharp and full of vibes just for you. Yes, Carol is saying that she will miss us on Wednesday. We will definitely miss you too, Carol. Michael, we'll definitely miss you. You're saying, oh no. So join us. Keep a lookout. We will be back on the 15th of September, and the full team will be here just to entertain you and show you all about Destination Jamaica. I will ask Geejam, any member of the team, just to say a quick wrap up for our session today. Christine, Newton, Kamla. All right.
So it was a pleasure having you guys, and I look so forward to seeing you, all of you, not just one, all of you, Geejam, sooner than later. We had a few rain yesterday and breeze, but we are good. The property is well clean and pristine right now. So it was a very nice session, lovely session. Jamaican Bununu session, and I look forward to many more, and persons who are on this to be sending their clients over to us. And trust me, they can't have nowhere better than Geejam to come to.
Amazing. Thank you, Newton. So the last not least, for £25 to Jamaica Rewards, make sure that you're signed up to our Jamaica Rewards. Please show your lottery hats on screen. I'm going to ask our regional director to select the lucky winner. So let's see who is wearing. Chrissy's wearing her hat. Carol is wearing her hat. Let's see who else. Anyone is wearing their hat? Liz, if you want to select the lucky winner. Drum roll. Yes, Neil is saying.
I'm just browsing through all these pictures. We don't seem to have any men wearing hats today.
Yes, Carol is in her hat, Tina is in her hat, Chrissy's in her hat.
No, I'm saying we haven't got any men wearing hats today.
Oh, men.
Donovan is there.
Donovan?
Only Donovan.
I can't see Donovan.
I could do the £25.
Oh, Donovan, now I see you. Okay, I didn't see you. Oh, so let's see. I think we have to go with Carol.
All right.
I mean, she looks like the queen, doesn't she? With the
you have to give us the wave, Carol, to say, yes, you will take the prize.
Well done, Carol.
All right, Carol, you will see that reward on your account shortly. So thank you everyone for participating. We will truly miss you in 3 weeks. Enjoy a wonderful time, you know, for the rest of the summer. Keep in touch. Let us know what exciting activities you're up to, and look out for the invitation when we resume on the 15th. Have a wonderful day.
Bye everyone. See you soon. I'll be more tanned next time you see me, hopefully, because I'm planning to sit in that sunshine. Bye-bye.
Bye.
We'll be right back.